Nobody likes to talk about money, right? Except me. I talk about money all day long. That's what I do for a living. I'm a health economist. We hear all the time about the rising cost of healthcare, but we don't hear a lot about the value of those investments, what those dollars buy. Take, for example, early intervention for autism. We've heard already from a couple of speakers today that it's very costly. We know that. A behavioral therapist may come to your home or to your child's daycare and work one-on-one with your child for hours at a time, 3, 4, 5 days a week. That's great, but really the question is, what is the value of that investment in early intervention? How do we know it's worthwhile? Well, for many kids, the results speak for themselves. When a child begins to make eye contact, starts to communicate, plays with other children, or has less anxiety, that's all good. But that's not the whole story. If we want to understand the real value of investing in early intervention for children with autism, we have to see what happens to these children when they grow up. So in this slide, you can see the average annual cost of autism pretty much over the lifespan till about age 65. And this cost to society as a whole for different levels of severity or different levels of dependency on supports and services. In the early years, in this preschool years, between the ages of 3 to 5, we know the costs are very high. They're about $70,000 per year, and this is because of the intensity of early intervention. Then when a child enters school at around age 6, the costs in fact go down, but they may be higher or lower depending on a child's particular needs or depending on what services are available in the school, in the community, in that jurisdiction. But look what happens in the adult years. The costs go up again, and they're sustained for many decades, particularly for individuals who are semi-dependent or very dependent on system supports and services. And these are individuals who can't participate in the workforce. In fact, about a quarter of the total cost, that cost of $100,000 per year, for the most dependent adults with autism is the cost associated with that loss in workplace productivity. So we know that the costs are very high. And the other thing that we know, in fact, is that we can see from this graph that the bulk of the costs are not, in fact, in the early years. They're over the many decades of adult life. And what researchers have shown, particularly some of the researchers you're hearing from today, is that if we can apply those early interventions, the right interventions, at the preschool and also during the school years to kids who need it and who will benefit from it, we can set them up on the right trajectory, on the right pathway, right from the beginning. And then we can shift that curve downward. So as I said, as we can see from this graph, the bulk of the costs don't occur in the early years, they occur in the adult years. And so what our research is continuing to show is looking at the cost effectiveness of different services and interventions for children. And if we can even avoid one child requiring extra services, if we can get one more child mainstreaming into regular education or being less dependent on social services, being able to get a job and keep a job for all their adult years, then we've done a good job. And then we understand really what the full picture of autism costs are. Thank you.